All right, and so now back to the discussion of what happens with we were having this vast illusion that there was a major player that was allowed to put all their savings and their loans into your banking system, okay? And that major player is not even in a local, is not a regional, is not even part of your country at all, just from somewhere else. Okay, so now I was trying to put this block in, and I'm trying to say, okay, 25% only allowed, you know, that creates a stability. So you don't have the carpet pulled out from underneath you. You know, that creates a stability in your government, in your economy. So if they go fickle, if they decide that, no, you're just a drunken brawl, we don't like you, you know, you don't have them withdrawing all their cash out of your banks. Okay, so that was the 25% limit. And you're like, well, who would limit, like, $1 billion? Who would limit it? That's stupidity. You know, just take it, and then for that time frame, you know, if they pull that billion out, you know, who cares? I don't know. It seems like you've wound up the people in the populace for that moment to happen or occur. You know, it just is not a stable economy. Because it's based upon this stranger or this strange group. Okay, so what I'm saying and I'm going with, this is like the others. Oh yeah, like they always have those movies and they have the others and they're always the creepy ones. Well, I guess there is a reason for it, because they are like another tribe. They are normally another culture. And when that goes on and you have overdone it, their acceptance, just because they're carrying currency, you know, just because of your greed, Phil, you know, you put yourself in an unstable situation. So let's say you decided with full heartedness that you're going to take that money, but you've also decided that you're not going to put your economy and your people at risk. Okay, so the best thing to do in that situation is tally it offshore. So if you are like a big Barclays or whatever, then you take those foreign deposits that are so massive and you have those offshore. So you deal with your offshore coordination that way. And so your own particular country is not going to fall. Do you understand? At the state of what's going on in that little offshore environment. You can still tally up your riches and your wealth offshore. You can still have investors investing in your company, the one that's offshore. But right then and there, you are not destabilizing, possibly, the economy of where you live. Okay? So that's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. So you want to do that to America? You want to say, okay, well, here is, you know, we'll bring in who? We'll bring in, I can't even bring in a place from Asia right now, but yeah, let's say Asia has just pouring in cash here. Can we put it on an island offshore and not be subject to its pandemonium, to its upheaval, to its quit? Do you understand? So it is actually like, let it falter elsewhere. Let it not falter near your people. You understand what I'm saying? So I don't know. I don't know what the United States offshore is. I mean, does anybody know? I believe there's, what, Bermuda? Is that an offshore? I guess you can go to one of those islands. You have the Outer Hebrides? No. You really do have islands out there. You have the Caribbean. You have plenty in the Caribbean. All right, so what is the plenty in the Caribbean? You have the British Virgin Islands. Well, those are great for Britain, you know. Okay, so, and then even the Netherlands can do this also. They have their Dutch islands. So let's do it that way. And so let's not put at risk your mainland populations. Okay, let's not put them at risk for unemployment, for all of a sudden, oh my goodness, you know. Whoops. You know, they own 75% of us. Yeah, so instead of allowing that to happen, yeah. Let's dictate an offshore where, go ahead and let it build up. And Americans could invest there, or British could invest there, or the French can invest there. You know, put it on your Guernsey. Let that happen. But that is a safety, that is a stability for your continent. That's a stability for your little tiny group of populace. And that's fair. It's absolutely fair. It's fair to your workers, it's fair to your businesses, it's fair to your people. All right? So yeah, woo, a billion. You know, everybody's excited. But yeah, that's a volatile. A billion from a stranger is a volatile.